Look carefully. The rest of the frontal gyrus here, that is the superior, the middle, and the inferior frontal gyrus. Okay. Now, on the orbital surface of the frontal lobe, what is there? You see, there is the S-shaped sulcus here. There is the S-shaped sulcus. Look. First, you see the inferior aspect. The inferior surface on this orbital surface, orbital part of this inferior surface, which is lying on the orbital plate, there is a sulcus. Can you see this sulcus? What is this sulcus? This is the olfactory sulcus, which is running anteroposteriorly. And this olfactory sulcus, what is the important structure? Anyone? This is the olfactory sulcus running anteroposteriorly, and there is a tract, the first cranial nerve tract, that is the olfactory tract. It will run over the olfactory sulcus here. Okay. Now lateral, and the gyrus here that you can see here, that is, this is the what? This is the gyrus rectus. Now lateral to that, there is an S-shaped gyrus. S-shaped sulcus, isn't it? So this S-shaped sulcus, seen on the orbital surface, it will divide the gyrus into the, this is the anterior part, the anterior, the posterior, the medial, and the lateral gyrus. Okay? Medial, posterior, the anterior, and the lateral. So this was the orbital surface. All these orbital gyri, as well the rest of the frontal gyrus on the superolateral surface, and on the medial surface, look here. Before going to the function, you have to see what are the structures on the medial surface. Look here. Look, this is what I am taking out. This is the branch of what? Which artery is this? Anyone? Which is winding around the superior border of the corpus callosum? Which artery it would be?
Anterior cerebral artery.
Yes, very good. Look here. This is the anterior cerebral artery. Very good. So, on the medial surface, you see, this is the anterior, the frontal pole, this is the occipital pole. Here there is a C-shaped structure which is known as the corpus callosum. This is the genu, this is the body, and this is the splenium of the corpus callosum. Splenium, it is the widest part posteriorly, and anteriorly this bend is the genu, and this is the recurved part. Recurved part of the corpus callosum here, which is known as the rostrum. What is it is? It is known as the rostrum of the corpus callosum. So, this we will discuss later. It's a very important topic, corpus callosum. We are concerned here with the sulci and gyri of the medial surface. So, on the medial surface, this around this corpus callosum, which there is a sulcus, it is known as what? Which sulcus?
Cingulate sulcus.
No, I am saying this is the callosal sulcus. Why it would be the cingulate sulcus then? This is not the anatomy. If I am saying this is the corpus callosum, just above the sulcus would be the callosal sulcus, no? And yes, there is a cingulate sulcus which is 1 cm above this callosal sulcus, isn't it? 1 cm above it is, this is the, which is running parallel to this callosal sulcus, it is known as the cingulate sulcus. Okay? You see here, this is the cingulate sulcus. So, there are two sulcus present on the callosal sulcus and the cingulate sulcus here. Okay? So, what is the structure in between these two sulcus, which is just above, that means gyrus, which is in between the callosal sulcus and the cingulate sulcus? What it would be? Yes, very good. That cingulate gyrus. So this is the cingulate gyrus. This is the topography. Okay. So this is the cingulate gyrus. Okay. Now this cingulate sulcus, it is running upwards here, and one part it is present here. So this is the paracentral lobule here. So one more sulcus, it is present here, that is the supraspinal sulcus. Okay, here, can you see? This is the supraspinal sulcus on the medial surface. This is what? This is the supraspinal, because splenium of the corpus callosum, it is here, and a transverse sulcus which is present here, that is known as what? The supraspinal sulcus. Now what part it is? Anyone? Which part of this is known as what? On the medial surface, what is the nomenclature of this gyrus here? This is the
precuneus.
Yes, very good. This is the precuneus. Very nice. This is the what sulcus is this? This is the parieto-occipital sulcus, and this was the calcarine sulcus. So the triangular area on the medial surface posteriorly, which lies in between the parieto-occipital sulcus as well as the calcarine sulcus, it is known as the cuneus. And just medial to that, the sulcus gyrus, it is known as the lingual gyrus. Okay, so this is the lingual gyrus here, this is the cuneus, and just anterior to this cuneus, the part which is bounded posteriorly by the parieto-occipital sulcus and anteriorly by the cingulate sulcus. Okay, upturned part of the seat. So this part, it is known as the precuneus. Okay, and anterior to that, this is the supplementary motor area here, paracentral lobule here, and anteriorly here it is the supplementary what area? Supplementary motor area, and rest of this, of the frontal gyrus, it is known as the medial frontal gyrus. What it is known as? Rest part of the frontal lobe, which is present on the medial surface starting from here to here, anterior part, that is rest part of the this gyrus on the medial surface of the frontal lobe, it is known as the medial frontal gyrus. And here it is the superior, the middle, and the inferior frontal gyrus on the superolateral surface, and the orbital gyri on the orbital surface. Okay, now the orbital surface, this medial surface with the medial frontal gyrus, and this the rest part of the superior, the middle, and the inferior frontal gyrus, it is known as what? Anyone? The whole of this gyri, it is collectively known as one area, a cortical representation of the frontal lobe.